today, they called us to make a diagnosis in a multi-V plus 4 system of the LG brand. After diagnosing, we reached the conclusion that it was the fan card which was damaged, so we proceed to uncover the electrical panel. In order to make the change, we remove the cover, and we find the entire electrical circuit there, obviously without voltage. Once we have removed the cover, we proceed to remove the connections from the noise filter card. These cards that are here in front, that you can see with those transformers, these coils of wound wire, they are called transformers toroidal, which are responsible for filtering the voltage, attenuating current peaks, to prevent damage to a sensitive electronic component that is further ahead of the circuit we proceed to remove. Well, this voltage, these voltage lines from here, since in order to do the work on the fan card of the fans, we need to disassemble this entire main electrical panel, which is in front, we can see here, which is a multi-plus system. From generation 4, you have to disconnect the plugs well to avoid any connector being pressed or subject, and that prevents us from being able to completely disassemble, well, the panel, and thus avoid any damage to any connector. Now we are going to proceed to remove 4 screws that the panel has. Once we have removed it, we proceed to disassemble it. The way to disassemble it correctly is pressing it up and then pulling it forward. Since it has some locks where the control panel rests, at the top, there we can see that you have already released the locks. Now we are going to proceed to disassemble them completely, to avoid damaging any cable or any part, and thus be able to work comfortably. The fan card, which is located exactly behind this card panel, which we are removing right now. Here we are removing the transformer connector, which is the one that feeds the outer card. We have already removed it, and we can see here. Now, what we have to change exactly is this card that we are touching is the one that we are going to change. We are going to remove the connectors or plug of the fans, the plug power supply of the card, the other fan, and the communication loop makes the communication loop between the card reverses and the fan card. Fans must be disconnected to be able to disassemble well. Be careful here, if you cannot damage this plug, because it is a bit delicate, so we are going to remove it. We are going to remove it now. Once we have removed all the connectors, we proceed to remove the screws from the card, which are 4 small screws at the 4 ends that must be removed, plus 4 screws, which are the ones that grip the intelligent protection module, which must be well tightened, since if it is not tightened well, or makes a false contact or is loose, it can generate heating in the module, causing us alarm and protecting the equipment. Now we can see that it is necessary to remove the 4 screws that hold the modules of this. Exactly these are the IPM modules, which are the intelligent power modules. They must be removed to be able to disassemble the card properly. Are really easy to remove these 4 screws. And now let's see that once we have removed the 4 screws, well, you just have to remove the insurance that the card base itself has to be able to remove it. The first thing we are going to do is check the card, because we already said that the card is damaged, but you have to see what happened or where the fault is, because to avoid putting a new card and that it is damaged again. Once we have removed everything, we have removed the screws, everything, then now it is only to remove the security insurance, such as you can see it is already disassembled. Ha, there it is. Look, there is the blow that the card has. Well, as we can see, well, there we have the damage it has suffered. We have measured the fuse, and it is cut. It has been damaged by some transient that entered towards the card near the protection module. Because there we can see the damage, we are going to remove the new one, as it will be the replacement, since here on this other card only one of the two fuses is fine as well, because the other, where is the damage or the short that was, because it is damaged, you always have to compare them, the card number and the one that brings the one to be changed. The number of vignettes that each card brings is compared. Sometimes it will not coincide. That depends on the type of production that has been. As you can see here, it does not match with the one it has, but we are going to observe it physically, since once we have compared the card, and we have seen that everything is fine, that it does match with all the electronic elements, well, we are going to proceed to install it. We have already applied its thermal paste. No, we could not record that, but if we already applied its thermal paste, that is essential in this type of inverter cards, since because it is power electronics, it generates excessive heat. And the thermal paste is very helpful, it is of much benefit, in order to maintain the proper working temperatures, with this type of cards, something other than no, we must never forget we cannot pass or skip this step, which are the screws that hold the module with the heatsink. Those screws that we are placing now are the ones that must always be installed. If a screw was lost for some reason or it was damaged, you must remove one and go buy another and replace it. But for no reason are you going to leave this card without paste and without these screws, since that causes direct contact between the IPM module that is the integrated one, the thermal paste, and the heat sink that is located just behind it, electronic card, which is a heat sink made of aluminum, which helps to cool, by means of air, the electronic cards, and thus avoid working with excessive temperatures, which can damage them, as we can see, which mainly the first thing to do is to place the four screws of the smart power modules. And when everything is ready and we have applied its thermal paste evenly, and the IPM screws we already assembled it, it is the first thing to do. Then we proceed to put the other four screws, which are from the outside, which are the ones that hold practically the entire card. One of these screws is no problem, you can leave it and it will not affect you at all, then you replace it. But a screw of the four that hold the two IPM modules, it is essential that you place them, because if you do not place it, as I explained earlier, there will not be direct contact with the heatsink, which will cause your module to power gets hot, and when it gets hot, it exceeds the allowed ranges or the data programmed in the desired limits, and usually when that happens, an error code will be generated, which will make your equipment stop for complete, avoiding proper operation. And that the client is complaining that the system is being paid every moment, because the module is heating up. That is why those four screws are essential. Now we just connect, and that's it. Let's start to assemble. Well, once we have placed the card, we proceed to reassemble the front card panel, which is the one that we had previously removed, to be able to work that card. And we do it in the same way as we disassemble. First we make sure that it rests on the locks, which it has on top, and once it has rested, it has fallen on the two locks, we just hold it and push it forward, to place the four security screws, which we remove at the beginning, and then we only connect the connectors that we have disconnected. This is the voltage connector that brings current to the external card, and we are also placing the security screws so that the cabinet does not fall, or it is going to move us for some reason, or someone finds it and it is going to come forward. It is deadly and dangerous that we touch voltage, so it is essential that those screws always be placed, for no reason. They are going to leave it only with the screws above, because if the cabinet is pulled by anyone who does not know and pulls it, it may have an accident, which would cause damage to the physical integrity of the person. Now let's see well how it is held, and now there is no problem or danger that will expose us to an accident, in that the voltage can seize us and suffer some damage. Now we only connect all the inputs of the noise control card. Well then, once we have connected everything on the fan card, and we have mounted the front panel, we connect the output cables of the noise filter card, which go to the inverter card. We make sure that these screws are tightened, since a false then or a loose screw, as it can cause overheating on the line and damage the card partially, perhaps not totally, but repairing these cards is not easy, so it is better to try to do things right. In the next video, we will show you how are we going to configure these systems so that you can start them up. Let's move the deep switches, the master-slave configuration, to be able to start it, and see the work of this completely. Subscribe to the channel. Thanks to those who stayed until this minute watching it. See you next time, and thanks for supporting us.